Well, Rob Evans is one of the world's top male models. Like, he's really, really, really ridiculously good-looking. He's in Australia at the moment and he's in our studio. But before we meet him, let's take a look at his incredible rise to stardom.
Rob Evans was discovered by a photographer scouting locations in a boxing ring. And it wasn't long before this 6'3" boxer began strutting his stuff on catwalks around the world. His face has graced the covers of countless magazines. He's had some fun with Madonna and was even invited to judge America's Next Top Model with Tyra Banks.
Please welcome Rob Evans. Hi, welcome to the show.
Hello.
Hello.
How are you?
Love that.
Hi.
Thank you.
Wow. It's nice to meet
big
you.
Hands.
Aren't you lovely?
You have phenomenal bone structure. You are such a big deal that a few of our stylists who are rostered off work today have come in especially to meet you.
Have they? Oh, that's sweet. That's sweet, I guess.
So how were you discovered?
In a boxing gym. A photographer come location hunting because it was a really old school boxing gym, like you can see all the beams and stuff like that. So it's a cool place to take pictures and yeah, he just come up to me, he's like, you should be a model. And at first I was like, get away, I'm a boxer, I don't want to be a model. And a couple of things happened and they started offering me to go to Paris, New York, so I just rolled with it and
if
I'm here now.
If you were a boxer, how did you keep your face in such good shape?
I was good. I was good.
Are you the greatest?
No, I was on that way though. That, in my head, I was. Boxing, it's like get hit. I mean, like hit and don't get hit. That's the main game. So, yeah, if you can do that, then.
Good on
and
you.
And, of course, if anyone picks on you for being a male model, you can take them out.
Boom.
Now, tell us about Madonna, because we were having a look at some pictures just before you came out of the clip you did with her.
Yeah.
That's seriously cool, isn't it?
Yeah, yeah.
What was that like working with her?
It was, it was cool because she's really nice. She's a really nice person. You know, sometimes people say she's a bit of a diva and stuff like that. I remember backstage people were like, get the models, and she would tell them, oh, they've all got names and blah blah blah. And she's just sometimes when you work in this industry, you'll do a job and as soon as you leave, then that's it. But she's the sort of person who will keep in contact with you and
she's kept in contact with you?
Yeah, at first, like not anymore, but like for about a year or so, she would invite me to parties and stuff like that.
Oh, wow. Really? Did you go to any of the parties?
Yeah, I went to a couple of Grammy parties and that. It's crazy.
Yeah.
It was
a hard life, isn't it?
It's crazy sometimes where I feel like seeing life, see if you want something, and you work towards it, once you get there, it's not that surprising. I never actually wanted to be a model, I wanted to do this. It's like one minute you're in a boxing gym, then the next minute you're on TV, you're on a TV show that you used to watch in your living room or you're partying with people like Madonna and other stars. It's surreal.
Male models don't get the same kind of hype as female models, do they?
No.
I mean, is that changing? It sounds like you're changing it.
It only changes if you're different. The thing with male models is once you see one male model, you've seen them all, they all kind of look the same.
And oh, no.
Now, where are we?
No.
I don't think so. That's not the same as other male models. Hello.
No, but this is what I was about to say.
I've got that as well. It's
this
okay,
is what I'm about to not. Say. As far as, like, when I come along, I was bigger, I was taller than most models, and I used to box. So the reason
and
why my
very
career...
masculine.
Yeah, the reason why my career went a different way is just because I didn't really fall into that whole... modelling thing is so...
I wouldn't mind asking, so I've obviously got my winter coat on at the moment. This is, in summer, this is not what it's like. Do you eat carbs?
Do I eat carbs?
Yeah, like, yeah, I mean, I love pasta.
Yeah, I do eat carbs. The thing with me is, like I'm saying, I'm not a stereotypical model. I don't fit clothes that well, so most of my modelling jobs have been like underwear and stuff like that, and I need to eat carbs to bulk up. Then once I've bulked up, then I'll.
Where's it going wrong for me though? Because I eat carbs.
It's because you're eating carbs, but you're eating carbs, but you're not. Are you working out with it?
That's probably the missing. Like,
yeah, that's
the missing point.
That's the key.
Yeah, okay.
Because Rob, obviously, you and I have similar body types. Do you find yourself under pressure? Like often you hear all this stuff about, you know, female models, they're under pressure to, you know, to not eat, to stay skinny. Do you feel? Are you objectified?
No.
Do you feel like you're treated like a piece of meat is what he's asking?
Yeah. It all depends how serious you take it. I'm not saying don't take it serious as far as show up to your job, be like professional, blah, blah, blah. It's like, as far as you, like I remember them telling me to lose a bit of weight so you can fit the clothes and blah, blah, blah. But I told them Like, I was a boxer first, so I'm going to stick to doing what I do. I'm going to stay working out. I'm going to stay as big as I want to do.
Do you still box?
Yeah, no, I don't compete anymore. I still train, though. Still train.
And most importantly, Rob, can you do a blue steel?
From Zoolander. Yeah.
Oh, right down there, right down there.
Yeah. Where are we looking there?
Oh, yeah.
Can you do another one? Down that one?
Just here?
Yeah.
Yeah, there you go.
You can heat up your dinner with that.
You're giving us all the vapors. Rob, thanks for coming
in. No worries. Thank you for having me.